Situated below the clock and arpeggiator in the central hexagon is Hive's versatile 16-step sequencer. As well as generating note data, it also outputs MIDI CCs and a gate signal for modulation purposes and even interacts with the arpeggiator. The number of steps in the sequence, from 2 to 16, is selected in the Steps menu. And sequences can be entered with the mouse or recorded via MIDI. To program a sequence using your MIDI keyboard, click the record button in the top bar. Each note played sets the transpose and velocity values for the current step and advances the sequence by one step, with the first note establishing the root pitch. When the sequence length exceeds the steps value, the latter will automatically increase by one with every added step. With your sequence created, switch from record to playback mode and hold down a note. The sequencer cycles until you release it, at the tempo defined by the clock above. With the sequencer being monophonic, when chords or legato lines are played, the last note received is used as the zero transpose root note, although it won't restart the sequence. For that to happen, a non-legato note has to be played. The sequencer can also record the output of the arpeggiator. Turn the arp on and play a chord to have the sequencer accept the resulting series of notes as if you were playing them on your keyboard. Each step in the gate lane of the sequencer toggles between on, tie, and rest when clicked. On plays a note on that step, offset from the triggering note by the number of semitones shown in the transpose lane below, from minus 24 to plus 24, and of a length determined by the gate dial to the right. Setting a step to tie tells it to output its note at maximum gate length. While selecting rest, silences a step completely. Tie and rest can only be selected on screen rather than by MIDI input. The velocity level of each step is entered in the velocity lane. With the dynamic velocity button activated, this value offsets the velocity of the triggering MIDI note. With dynamic velocity turned off, the velocity setting is absolute regardless of MIDI input. When the arpeggiator is turned on, its output is used as the basis for the sequence. While the sequencer always runs at the specified clock speed, the arpeggiator's frame parameter can be used to slow down the triggering arpeggio, creating all manner of interesting melodic shapes. To shift the whole sequence left and right, click the rotate buttons. in playback mode, as well as note data, the sequencer can also output one of five MIDI continuous controllers, chosen from the menu below the rotate buttons. As with note data, you can enter the per step values for the selected CC manually, or capture them in record mode by tweaking the controller in question on your keyboard, mod wheel most obviously, while playing notes to progress through the sequence. To use the MIDI sequence as a modulation source, simply assign that controller to a target in the modulation matrix. To kill the note data and only output the MIDI CC and set gate, which we'll return to in a moment, switch to modulator mode. The sequencer can also be used as a gate-style modulator, called SetGate in the modulation matrix. In modulator or playback mode, assign SetGate to a target to have the gate lane modulate that parameter by plus 100 with every on or tied step and 0 on every rest step. The attack and decay controls adjust the fade in and out time of the SetGate signal, while the gate dial sets how long it stays open for each step. Finally, sequences can be saved and loaded as presets via the preset menu at the bottom of the hexagon.